let's talk about disease scouting and day-neutral strawberries. So first, we're going to be in this row and we're going to investigate some of our fruit rot diseases. And for us in day-neutral strawberry production, one of the biggest things we've observed is anthracnose fruit rot. And that's what we're looking at right here. Anthracnose fruit rot is going to be characterized by these sunken and dark lesions on the fruit. And anthracnose can really be severe in situations where these fruits, as you can see, kind of hanging over into this grass line. Now, when this grass is grown pretty high and sitting high, this is accumulating a lot of moisture and creating a microclimate that's very conducive to the spread and infection of this pathogen, causing these rotted fruits. And you'll see more along the grass line here. Contributing to this or exacerbating the situation for anthracnose fruit rot can be plastic mulches, which we see right here. These kind of smooth plastic mulches, because this fungus does well in water, these mulches create kind of a surface for water to bounce and splash off of and cause new infections on healthy fruit, resulting in these lesions. Now, we do see a couple other fruit rots in our day-neutral strawberry production as well. For instance, botrytis fruit rot is another disease that we commonly observe, and this is oftentimes a factor of having a dense canopy. So this particular disease likes a dense canopy because it likes humidity and that stagnant air. It forms a grayish velvety growth over the fruit and causes just a complete deterioration of the fruit. The final thing that we might observe in the strawberry production system in terms of fruit rot would be leather rot. And leather rot is also another disease that we tend to see on fruits that are making contact with that soil line because they're making contact with a lot of excessive moisture. This leather rot will in fact cause truly that, a rot that looks leather-like in appearance and can completely mummify the fruit. Leaf spots are another common disease that we encounter in our day-neutral strawberry production, and there are three leaf spots that we typically see. The first that I'll mention is common leaf spot of strawberry, and this disease is characterized by purple lesions with tan centers. And this pathogen is typically only really a cosmetic issue, but if it's not managed, it can actually start to reduce plant vigor. The second disease that we often see is leaf blight. And this leaf blight can be characterized by some lesions on leaves that typically kind of are delineated by the veins and cause V-shaped necrotic lesions on the leaves. And again, this is another leaf spot that we see that can oftentimes be cosmetic, however, if not managed, can actually reduce plant vigor and cause economic losses to your strawberry production. And the final disease that we typically see is leaf scorch. And we haven't seen it a ton in our day-neutral strawberry production, but it causes purple lesions without tan centers. So that's how you're gonna differentiate it from common leaf spot. And that disease, again, fairly cosmetic and can be managed with regular fungicide applications. Now, when it comes to managing some of the diseases we've talked about, including both fruit rots and these foliar diseases, what is most important to remember is reducing the amount of water on the foliage or the fruits themselves is really going to help minimize those diseases. These fungal pathogens thrive in moist environments, so reducing that water on those surfaces is really going to help manage these diseases. Verticillium wilt is another disease that we've encountered here in our day-neutral strawberry production. Now, verticillium, the pathogen, actually overwinters in soil and plant debris, and that's likely what contributed to the outbreak that we've seen in our day-neutral strawberry production here. So verticillium wilt, what I mean by this is literally wilting of the plants, an overall decline of the plant. And this pathogen actually infects into the root and crown tissues of the plant, so we're not going to see the actual manifestation of the pathogen unless we pull up the plant and cut open the crown. But we will see the results of that wilting or that loss of those water conducting channels being clogged up by this pathogen. So what we're looking at here is kind of really a situation where we're seeing kind of multiple stages of verticillium wilt going on here in this particular row of strawberries. And this wilting resulted in wilting of the leaves, which ultimately results in kind of their browning and overall decline of the plant. So these plants are going to have to be pulled out. Now, one of the important ways to manage verticillium wilt is that when you plant your strawberry, your day-neutral strawberries, plant them in ground that has not been previously a plant host of verticillium. So a lot of these crops include solanaceous crops, maybe such as potato or peppers and things of that nature. And unfortunately, this ground was previously planted to some of those crops and likely contributed to an inoculum source of verticillium, causing some of the symptoms that we see here today.